So what are the seven barriers you're likely to face as you start your property journey? And this video really is about tackling that. Now, the key thing about if you're watching this video is that you've decided that property investing, either full time, as a side hustle, or passively, is how you're going to be building your long-term wealth or generating income on a daily basis. Now, regardless of whatever strategy you've decided to employ, you are undoubtedly going to face one or more of these seven barriers, especially in your first year. And for some of them, you'll be dealing with them as you go along on your property journey, but you just need to overcome them. And the great thing about all of them is that there are ways to overcome them that really is all about you applying yourself and seeking the right help. So quickly, let's go into number one. Now, number one is the one area that most people think is the biggest barrier to get into property investing, and that is money. So money typically tends to be the reason why people say, "Oh, I can't get into property investing. I don't have enough money." But there are strategies and there are ways to get around money as the primary barrier. Now, there are different strategies that employ, say, rent to rent, in which you need less cash to get into, or there are even some strategies in which you don't even need that much. You're really just leveraging off your existing networks. Now, there are all these different ways that you can get into property that won't necessarily involve you starting out with money. So, whilst money can appear to be a limiting way or a barrier to you progressing your property journey, it tends to really not be the issue, but maybe the eventual cause of the real issue, which is that you don't understand some of the strategies that you could potentially be using. So that's money is number one. Number two is access. And by access, I mean access to, say, knowing, let's say you had funds parked and you were going to invest these funds. Number one, access to the right property, access to the right agents that can get you the right properties, access to the right areas, having access to leverage, for instance. Because one of the key things that you will realize in your property journey is that leverage is one of the key ways to scale quick. If you want to start using cash to buy a property, first of all, you get very poor return on your investment, especially if you're investing in the UK or in, say, London, especially as you go further south. But also, you'll find that leverage is a way you can quickly scale up. So rather than buy, say, one property with £300,000, you can buy three properties with the same amount of starting out deposit. So just understanding that access to leverage, but there are key areas that you need to work on to be able to access leverage, making sure you have the right credit report, making sure you take care of your finances and that you build yourself, you build that aspect, your financial history very well as you go along. So being very clear about access. So access to properties, access to estate agents, access to the networks, because sometimes a property is really about the network that you have. So your network is your net worth. That's a very well-known saying, and that's because it is true. So access is one of the key areas you will find that will be a barrier in your first year. The third thing is usually fare. And fare is that because you haven't been down this road before, you know, you've never invested. If you have a pot of cash, you've never invested that amount of cash, I promise you, in anything else, unless, you know, there are other things you could potentially get into. But primarily, property is about the highest value asset that you will be buying. And so it's not something to take lightly. And therefore, the fare is a well-known barrier that can sometimes hinder you from being able to move to the next level or be able to invest as much as you normally would have because that fare holds you back. And there are ways to overcome fare. One of the key ways to overcome fare is what I call borrowed experience, where you're working with someone who's already been down this path and you're able to then overcome your fear because that person can assure you that, look, don't step here, go here, do this, invest in this, and it can help you overcome that fear because really that fear is based on the next point, which is lack of knowledge. So a lot of times you don't have enough knowledge going into something. I advocate that you get knowledge, but don't just get knowledge, i.e., getting different courses and not doing anything with it. Make sure that as you're getting the knowledge, you are developing on that knowledge. You're using that knowledge that you've gained and you're progressing and you're taking quick steps and simple steps along to move your property investing journey forward. Now, the key thing with knowledge is that a lot of times you can get knowledge. You know, there's a lot of knowledge now online, everywhere. And it's really just making sure that you tap into the core source that provides you knowledge that you can work with. It's not just about doing courses, it's about being able to apply the knowledge that you have, which is the next point, which is all about experience. And remember, I talked about borrowed experience. Now, a lot of times, your own experience will be a major barrier in your first year and in your as you start in your journey. Because, of course, like I said, you've never been through this, you've never charted these waters before. So your experience, you don't have that experience. You might have the knowledge, you may have taken a course, but you don't have the experience as to what exactly to do. Sometimes you don't even know where to start from, who to call, what agents, what area, how do you know this area is the right area to invest in? You know, it's like you almost need to be in it. And there's something that I quote where I talk about how sometimes with experience, you know, when you're investing, you understand that there's known factors, there's not known information. Check the news, you have information, but then there's also the experience that you have, which is based on intuition, that this is indeed a right deal. This is the right property to put my money in out of the different properties that I've seen, because the experience gives you that confidence and that assurance that this step, whilst it's unknown, I've been down this path before. Again, another way to overcome it is through, again, through borrowed experience, where you're leveraging off somebody else who has been down this path and can explain to you the what to do, how to do it, and give you almost a guided path so you can achieve. Because it's not enough to just have the knowledge, you need to work on that knowledge. And then the next thing is the ability to take risks. With every business that you are starting out, you will inherently be taking risks. The whole point of business is that, you know, you're taking calculated risks. Now, the bigger the risk, usually the bigger the rewards, but you want to balance that, and you want to make sure that whatever risk that you're taking, you've calculated it. And I say the one way to mitigate against risks is by making sure that you've assessed all your scenarios. So you have your best case, your worst case, and your normal case scenarios, and what you will do if any of them was to occur. But what COVID-19 has taught us is the fact that you should also have a worst case scenario, which is if in case of death or in case of anything really drastic that you couldn't have possibly planned for, what I call these outlier occurrences, that you have an exit scenario even for that. So once you have all of these exit scenarios laid out and you've had a sense checked by somebody who's more experienced, then you can take the step knowing fully well that you can take that risk to do whatever it is and therefore get the reward. And the final point in terms of the barriers to getting on your property journey, barriers in your first year of your property journey, and generally barriers, is your mindset. Mindset, mindset, mindset. And the reason why I say mindset is because it covers things like limiting beliefs, things that you think that you're not good enough to be able to do because you don't have enough understanding, you don't have the ability to do it. Those types of things are down to mindset. And the key thing about mindset is that it plagues you throughout the entire journey. Even in my own journey, I find that going from one step to the next step, you buy one property, say you buy it with one strategy. As you flip into the next strategy, you then have that knowledge gap and that experience gap. Your mindset generally will be what will help you to push through to be able to do it, regardless of having the experience or not. So being able to work on your mindset, and that's why you find a lot of people that are in property do a lot of self-development, and they need to understand themselves, understand how their mind works, how to get the best from yourself, how to get the best out of you, how you can get yourself more productive, even when you're scared, how you can push through that fear and achieve results. So very important. Another thing with mindsets is also this thing of imposter syndrome. And imposter syndrome really does come when you're having conversations, say, with other people, and you're having conversations, say, with an investor. That's a good example, where you want to convince an investor to come alongside, but you almost don't have the confidence to be able to go and meet the person and explain what it is that you have, the proposition. You feel like you're begging. No, actually, once you understand who you are and understand the confidence and have the confidence to be able to present what it is that you have, you are benefiting that person. So understanding that mindset is all about you and developing yourself to be able to almost be able to increase your capacity to do more. So those are what I would say are the seven core difficulties and challenges that you're typically going to face as you get started in property. Of course, like I've said, with all of them, there are ways to get around it, and there are ways to overcome them so that you can be successful. So if you want to find out more, definitely check out my blogs and my podcast, propertymom.co.uk. Also, we are launching a new platform, which is called Property Kept Simple. And the whole idea is to keep property concepts simple, but workable, so that you can take step-by-step action to be able to move on to the next level of your property journey. So definitely check that out when we launch. And one more thing, if there's any one of these barriers that you're facing currently, do drop me a line either by email, you can find me on Instagram, and let me know where you are finding difficulties. Either is it with your money, is it with your mindset, is it with access, is it with knowledge, is it with experience, and is it with ability to take risks? So any one of those are difficult, or if it's a multitude of them, just let me know. Okay then.